This is my Tandy 1000SL. While I have this thing apart, I figured I might as well do a video showing you what's inside and some of the upgrades you can do. This is an XT class machine, which comes with an 8 megahertz Intel 8086 processor and 5 8-bit ISA expansion slots. And it comes with 384K RAM on the motherboard, expandable to 640K. So if you come across one of these with only 384K, it's a very easy upgrade. Just these 8 chips here, you just get some 41464 chips and put them in, and that upgrades you from 384K to the full 640K. Now here's the CPU, and this has also been upgraded in this to a NEC V30 chip. That gives you a performance boost of anywhere around 10 to 30% over the 8086. And it also lets you run a lot of software that would only normally run on a 286, because the V30 has many of the 286 instructions. The only thing it doesn't have is protected mode. So anything that runs in real mode and normally requires a 286 will usually run on a V30. And next to it, with the fancy gold thing on it, which is actually real gold, is the Intel 8087 math coprocessor, which is another upgrade you can do. It's not really useful if you're just playing games, but if you're using something like a spreadsheet program or some kind of math software, it will take advantage of the coprocessor. And this one actually was intended for use with a NEC PC9801 series computer. That was a popular series of non-IBM compatible computers in Japan. They were never sold here in the USA or anywhere else outside of Japan for that matter. But it's the same 8087 chip that would be normally used in a regular PC, so it works fine here. And here is another upgrade I did just recently. It's a Dallas clock chip, because the 1000SL does not normally come with a real-time clock. So normally, every time you turn on the computer, you would have to enter the correct time and date, otherwise it would show up as 1980. But with this chip installed, it keeps the time and date, so you don't have to type it in. I got this for about 10 bucks on eBay from Hong Kong. The shipping took about 3 weeks or so. It took quite a while to get here, but it finally did arrive, and I just stuck it in the socket here. And the date it came programmed with was only about 2 days behind, so I just entered the correct date, and it's been keeping good time ever since I installed it. So that was a perfect, easy upgrade. And probably the most important upgrade for anybody wanting to use a 1000SL these days is a 3.5-inch disk drive. Now, the disk drive and the frame it's mounted in are standard IBM PC compatible parts, but the way it's connected is rather special. Like most Tandy computers, the 1000SL does use a special floppy cable, because it supplies the power to the disk drives through the cable, which was used by the proprietary 3.5-inch disk drives that Tandy used. But since normal PC type floppy drives do not use power supplied through the cable, they get separate power connectors. Tandy punched little holes in the cable to disconnect the power from getting through the cable. Otherwise, it would fry the drives by supplying power in lines that are normally used for ground connections. So if you want to use a different floppy cable, you have to replicate those holes. Otherwise, you'll fry your disk drives. But I elected to keep the standard Tandy floppy cable, and I managed to find an adapter that would fit, because this cable, as you can see, is very short. So the normal adapters that only come out to about here, they're just a piece of circuit board, won't work because the cable won't reach. So I was able to find this one that it's mounted on an actual little piece of cable here, so I was able to get it to reach. And I also use an adapter to convert the big power connector to the little power connector that 3.5-inch floppy drives use. Another complication is that Tandy 1000s don't use a twist in the floppy cable between the A and B drives like normal PCs do. You can see the cable is completely straight between the two drive connectors, because instead of using the twist, they use the drive select jumpers on the drives to indicate which one is drive A and which one's drive B. Now, the thing that complicates that is most 3.5-inch floppy drives are hardwired to drive select 1, so you can't change them. So this one is actually wired up as if it's going to be drive B, and then this one is wired up as if it's going to be the A drive, drive select 0. If you want to keep the Tandy cable, that's how you have to wire these all in place. You have to get one of these adapter cables that gives you enough room to reach the drive. You need an adapter for the power cable, and since the 3.5 drive is fixed to drive select 1, you have to make the other drive select 0. And another thing I did is I rewired the power supply fan to run at 5 volts instead of 12 volts, because normally it blows way more air than this computer needs to cool itself, and it was making too much noise. So I just rewired it to run on 5 volts, and it still blows out enough air to keep it cool, and it's much quieter. Another thing you'll probably want to do is add a hard drive, but you notice there's only 2 drive bays. So if you want 2 floppy drives, you notice there's no room for it. Well, if you use a 3.5-inch drive, I suppose you could find some way to duct tape it to the side here, maybe using double-sided tape or something, or make some kind of bracket. But instead, I went with a hard card, which was what Tandy would sell you back in the day if you wanted to add a hard drive to one of these. It's really just a hard drive mounted on a card with the matching controller. This is a Seagate ST-351A/X, which is unique because it can work as either an 8-bit or a 16-bit IDE drive. And since this is only an 8-bit expansion slot, you need one that is compatible with an 8-bit controller. So that's what's special about this drive, and this is the matching controller for it. The Seagate ST-05X. A little bit hard to find these days, but if you set up a search on eBay and wait a while, you can find one. So there's the hard card installed, and this one did not come with a bracket to help support it, so I had to make my own. And it's a good idea if you're gonna ship one of these computers, or even just bring it in a car somewhere, it's a good idea to remove the hard card and pack it separately, because you don't want this thing rattling around inside the case, because it puts a lot of stress on the slot there to help support it. So you don't want it to put too much stress on that slot if you're moving this thing around. It's okay if you're just carrying it around, but if you're going to be shipping one of these in a box somewhere, it's good to take this out and pack it separately. So now that your Tandy 1000SL has been upgraded with extra RAM, a V30 CPU upgrade, an 8087 math coprocessor, a Dallas real-time clock, a hard card, and a 3.5-inch floppy drive, you can finally turn it on and enjoy all those extra upgrades you just did. And there it is. So now we can check the time and date. There it is, Saturday, September 14th, 2013. So I didn't have to type that in. It automatically came up thanks to that clock chip. And hard drive's working fine. And there's our directory listing of the hard drive. And there's one other trick you can do, because, like I said, 3.5-inch floppy drives are usually hardwired to drive select 1. Which normally means you can only use it as the B drive. But you can change that. If you use the setup SL program that the Tandy comes with, there's a website called oldschool.org, which has a disk image of the original MS-DOS disk that the 1000SL and TL came with. And it comes with that setup SL program if you don't have it. And you see an option here, diskette drive A designation top or bottom. And if you set it to bottom, that swaps the 2 drives. So now this becomes the A drive, and this becomes the B drive. So even though the cable's wired up so that this is the A drive and this is the B drive, that swaps it. So now it's reversed. To prove it, I'll put in a disk in a 3.5-inch drive, and I'll type DIR A colon. And it's reading the 3.5-inch disk. And there's our directory of the files on it. And if I put in a 5.25-inch disk and I type DIR B colon, there it goes, and there's our directory of the files on the 5.25-inch drive. And since the Tandy 1000SL was the world's first PC to come with built-in digital audio recording and playback capability, I'll leave you with some music played on the Tandy 1000SL.
This is Splitins. So, sorry to all you people who like guitars and whining and stuff. I hate you.
I got you. That's all I want.
I listen to headphones most of the time. Speakers are for people with money.